This is the project that I'm working on now at the moment. It is a crystal oscillator, and that oscillator is here. And here you see the waveform from that crystal oscillator. I've already published that on YouTube. But I want to feed the sine wave into the 7400 chip that's here. So here is the complete setup. But this video is not about how I manage that all, but it is about the power supplies that you need for such a demo circuit. And also for a real circuit, not only demo. And that's why this video is called Project a 10 MHz Crystal Oscillator, the pre-work. Before it all starts and you have a successful circuit, there's a lot of pre-work to do. And in this case I have drawn this schematic. Here is the crystal oscillator, sine wave out, here the 7400 chip, logical chip, and here another transistor that's here. And the function from that transistor is that when the chip here, the 7400, doesn't give a good square wave out, I want to repair that with this transistor. But anyway, the pre-work is also about the power supply. Every electronic circuit is as good as its power supply. That's an old rule in electronics. So here in this video I want to tell more about the power supply. Here is the general power supply that I've made. So it gives at the moment 12 volts, and here there is a voltage stabilizer and a circuit that drops the voltage to 5 volts because the 7400 needs 5 volts. So here we have the classical stabilized voltage supply, 1K5 resistor, Zener diode from 6.2 volts, bridged by a 10 microfarad capacitor. You can change the Zener voltage to 6 volt or 5.8 volt, but of course in that case you have a somewhat lower voltage out. This is very important here, what happens here. 100 nanofarad cap, 270K resistor that bridge the positive from the chip to the negative here. This unit damps out all disturbing voltages on the supply line, and that's here in this case. Here. It's very important to tell that when you make such a setup with long wiring and you use an oscillator on 10 MHz, there will be disturbing effects from the wiring, and when it is too long it can change the frequency somewhat or cause harmonics or whatever. And that's why I made it all this way. These circuits here, this circuit here, this circuit here, has the objective to damp out all disturbing voltages on the power supply line. So a kind of decoupling circuit. And also here, the 12 volt sine wave oscillator is connected here to the 12 volt, but I've also mounted here in that unit this circuit. I haven't drawn it here on the on the schematic, but also here we have a capacitor from 10 microfarad, a resistor from 100K or 500K, and a capacitor from 100 nanofarad. That's the best thing to do when you make experimental circuits in this way, on a breadboard with quite long wiring. But anyway, when you make it, this circuit, on a board with short wiring, you can encounter the same problems. So that's why you need decoupling units like this one here, and here also a decoupling unit, to make that the whole circuit works properly and works very stable. And that's very important. Important, a good decoupled power supply to all the electronic units that you use in your circuit.